Hi, I'm Catherine Duffy, and we're about to get started on a video series that's going to take you through temporary difference income tax accounting method under IFRS, applying the Canadian tax laws in the example. So the first thing we're going to get looking at is some base facts to start an example with. So these are the facts of the income tax situation that I'm going to use to illustrate the tax accounting. So just to remind everybody, the method of tax accounting that we're using here is under IFRS called the temporary difference method, and it's sometimes referred to as a deferred tax accounting method. So that's what we'll be applying in this example. The tax rates that I've made up for this situation were for the base year from last year, 2015, as well as the current year, which is the year we're going to be doing the tax accounting for, are 20%. And then for every year from 2017 and beyond, we'll assume a tax rate of 15%, and that's known right now in the year 2016. Other facts that are relevant to the tax accounting for this year are the property, plant, and equipment assets, which I'll use the abbreviation PPE sometimes. Given at the end of last year, December 31st, 2015, they had a net book value of $40,000, so gross value of $55,000, accumulated depreciation of $15,000, but the only thing that's relevant here for the tax accounting is the net book value of $40,000, and we'll assume that they're going to depreciate $2,000 a year straight line basis. So in 2016, it'll be another $2,000 of depreciation expense booked. The undepreciated capital cost allowance, in the short form UCC, for tax purposes, December 31st, 2015, the UCC was $25,000. We'll assume a made-up tax class that has a CCA, or capital cost allowance rate, of 12% for this particular class of assets. And then the other relevant fact for this tax accounting situation is that at the end of last year, December 2015, there was a warranty liability that had been accrued but not spent yet of $80,000. These tax facts are all going to be based on the Canadian Tax Act as it stands right now in 2016. So more facts that are relevant to the 2016 fiscal year that we're doing the tax accounting entries for. You need to have a starting point, and the best starting point is usually the accounting net income, which is $80,000 before tax journal entries have been booked. Other facts that are going to be relevant to this tax accounting situation that have already been accounted for in the financial statements in the general ledger for 2016 include the following items. We've got depreciation expense that was booked of $2,000. We've got dividend income from Canadian corporations of $8,000 that's been recorded. There were some fines paid for some type of item that was fined this year, $3,000 that's been expensed in the $80,000 of net income. There were some repairs done to some products that we sold in prior years, and we've accrued a warranty on that, as you saw from the original facts, that there was a warranty liability. And the repairs that were done cost us $8,500 this year and would have been just charged against the warranty and didn't need to be expensed. There's a restructuring liability that was accrued this year that was expensed of $10,000 because we plan to shut down a location next year. None of that's been spent yet, so there's still a $10,000 liability in our balance sheet. There's rental income that has been accrued and is sitting in receivables still of $6,000. It was earned this year but has not yet been collected. And finally, there's some meals and entertainment expenses of $7,500 were booked for this year, and we'll come to that, but only 50% of those meals and entertainment expenses are deductible for tax purposes. Okay, those are the facts that we're going to use for this example. So thanks for watching, and whenever you're ready, move on to the next video, which will take you through the step one calculation of current income tax expense.